Hallelujah, Jesus. I worship you.
Yes.
Let the words I speak
that your name will be glorified. I pray that you will let the words I speak be effective so that we, your people, will be edified. I pray that you will let the words I speak be effective so hell will be horrified.
Yes.
At the knowledge that we, your people, by your word, are empowered.
Yes.
In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen.
Amen.
So today, Overseer Robinson, he pretty much just tore apart everything that I was about to say. I mean, I know that was God because he was right along the lines of what I was going to speak about. So I'm just going to back him up with a few scriptures and a few words and I'm going to get out of the way. Amen?
Amen.
So today I will be using for a title, Worship and the Power of Worship. The definition of worship is a feeling or an expression of reverence and adoration. From the definition, we already know that worship is an emotional moment between you and God. As you all know, I've been in church all my life. From an early age, I learned how to church. I learned how to sing, dance, shout, testify, all of that. But it was in my latter days that I really understood and came to know the meaning of worship. Now your story may be a little bit different from mine as to how you arrived at the knowledge and the power of worship. But I arrived at the knowledge and the power of worship through my many problems and troubles. Again, I say I would come to church as a young boy, sing, shout, just imitating what I saw. A lot of you know for many years I played the drums. I did it all. I churched. In my older years, I got married at a very early age. I was 21. I've been married to my wife for 25 years. Let me say this. When we got married, we was probably one of the ones that people bet on they weren't gonna make it. 25 years later, I still love Tisha like I did the first day. I'm not saying that I'm perfect and I've been a perfect husband, but my love for my wife is genuine and authentic. I love her and I know she loves me back. Back to learning how to church. It was my adult years being married and having children and really faced with real life issues. As a child, you know, all we really had to do was get up, take a bath. Some of us that took a bath when we was young, because you know, y'all, when we was young, we didn't take a whole lot of baths. Well, we were ready to run and play, but we would get up and we would run. So at my earlier, you know, my older years, I say 21, but not older, you know, I was faced with real life issues. Bills, children, I'm 24 years old, I don't know how to be a father. You know, real life issues.
Yeah, go ahead.
So I would come to church, still knowing how to church, I would sing, testify, play the drums. All of that was in my older years. And let me say this to the young people that may be listening. You don't have to wait until you marry to really understand the power of worship.
That's right.
Worship is an effective tool that can help you through any situation.
Yeah.
I don't care what the situation is. Could be peer pressure. You're dealing with peer pressure from somebody to take drugs or to have sex. I'm telling you, if you use this weapon, and it's a weapon, worship is a weapon.
Yes, it is.
If you use this worship weapon, it is effective in helping you through every situation.
Yes.
So many times I would come to church Monday, Tuesday night as a child. But first, in the home, I would see my mother sometimes just, you know, she would be doing her chores and, you know, she would be singing. And all of a sudden, I would see mom start crying. I'm like, Lord, here we go. Never understand. Come to church on Monday and Thursday nights. We came to church every Monday and Thursday nights. Y'all like, good. We didn't have a choice. I would see the older saints like Aunt Bessie, Mother Gross, Missionary Jackson, just to name a few, Elder Grandison. They would come in, Grandma Hill, they would come in and they would sing these songs, and tears would begin to flow down their face. And we as children, we had no idea what was going on. But today I know they were worshiping. So I'm gonna get to my scripture. I will be coming from Mark chapter 5, verses 1 through 8. Elder Sarko, if you would, could you have to read? Mark chapter 5, verses 1 through 8.
Amen. Mark chapter 5, verses 1 through verse 8. And they came over onto the other side of the sea, into the country of the Gadarenes. And when he was come out of the ship, immediately there met him out of the tombs a man with an unclean spirit, who had his dwelling among the tombs, and no man could bind him, no, not with chains, because that he had been often bound with fetters and chains, and the chains had been plucked asunder by him, and the fetters